The director and writer, not here right now, but he came up with the senior thesis at college. And it's about how he can have relationships and also how he still acts like a child in life. And so that's the basis.
Where did you guys shoot it?
Santa Cruz at Panther Beach, and that's my idea. That's a little
for the elevator, there's a lot of different techniques as well as different effects that were made in and played with in the film, which made the film absolutely great and incredible. You want to talk about how you make those artistic decisions to kind of make that film really pop?
Just used what we had and tried to really concentrate on, building funny moments out of the footage that was available. And I mean, I had a lot of good stuff to work with, so it was.
You did it
with God. Yeah, it felt right. So you just put it together, and it happens sometimes accidentally. So that's about as best as I can put it.
The question was, have any of you or do you plan on making the jump to feature films?
I'd like to ask everyone to go see Take Me Home tonight.
So I just want to know where you guys are all from.
Los Angeles.
I live in Seattle.
Yeah, cool.
I'm in LA.
From Arizona.
LA.
From Los Angeles.
I'm in Pedaluma in San
Diego. I'm sorry, I have to follow you. You're too much scary.
I'm sorry.
We're always a bride. That was such a great help. Do you have some personal experience on this? Perhaps you just sit around one night and think about that?
No, I don't have any personal experience with it other than growing up in Los Angeles and living in LA. It just seems like at a certain point, everybody I knew started to get divorced. And I just thought it would be funny and actually pretty typical in Los Angeles for somebody to feel like they might miss out on all that. So.
So does that also come from a personal experience? Is this something that you can relate to that?
This is actually a biographical film about my conception. I'm naturally very awkward. So the idea of making an awkward comedy about losing your virginity came a little naturally. I think it stemmed from me getting drunk with my friends and us all talking about our first times, and that was kind of, you know, someone had the drunk story. Mine involved the movie Armageddon, which I don't want to go into. But yeah, I mean, I think everybody's been there, so it didn't really take much to sort of write to that. Yeah.
All right,
I got two, if it's okay. First one is for Abby. I love the coloring in the movie, and it reminded me of like French movies, like Love Me If You Dare and all that stuff. I was wondering if that is your inspiration in taking those artistic choices.
Let me repeat that one just so that everyone can hear. So this was for Abby, and she was saying that it reminds her of her French film and the choices that were made. And you
want to
comment on that? Okay.
Yes, Zach, the director, and I, we both really love Crouching Way, but the art and session. The colors definitely take them out, like a lot of red and blues. His brother did all the drawings for the film, and so we're also really inspired by those, and the colors in that were really primary colors.
The second question is for Andy Made a Friend. I was wondering if you can tell us your inspiration for that one, because it was really funny.
Good girl.
I don't know what day I came up with the idea. I think I was watching Kristen Wiig on something, and I just remember thinking, like, she takes the most ridiculous circumstances and owns them and just makes them so normal. And I think that's what just came of a chick who pees her pants and that. And then just, like, what that looks like with her living in the world and stuff. And so I wrote the script and then passed it to my brother,
and we made the film.
You wrote the fart part.
Yes, yeah, you know.
Coming back to Ashley, you were really good in both films. I thought you were really good. Are you actor? Are you producing? Are you writing? Are you doing everything? Or where do you want to go?
Where do you want to go? That was basically the question.
Acting is the main thing. That's what I enjoy and I love. But it just kind of got to the point where I was like, hey, there's nothing out there that I want to do, so I need to make it myself. And then got together with this one and got an amazing crew together. And so we just started making films, and we're addicted. It's fun. But eventually, I mean, acting would be, I would love to act in someone else's thing and go from there. But I've been having fun learning all the different, I mean, there's so much that goes into film. Like, it's amazing. So, yeah, acting.
Yes.
I have a question for Heather. Moving into directing, what made you want to do that, and what did you think of the experience?
I like to make my own films at home, and like I always did like online movie and stuff. So it was just something that when we started writing it, I asked her if I could do it. Now, for those who do
It is a 19-minute film.
A what film? A 19-minute film?
9-0.
Wow. 9-0? No, I don't think so.